हेलो एवरीबॉडी, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एडिंग ए कंट्रोलर इनटू एग्जिस्टिंग स्प्रिंग बूट वेब प्रोजेक्ट। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो व्हिच आई विल शेयर इन द description box, what we had done, we had created a Spring Boot web application. We went for running index.jsp inside that Spring Boot web application. In this video, we will add extra thing into it. We will go for creating a login project, means we will authenticate the user by asking the user ID and password. With the help of a controller, we will validate the user ID and password, and accordingly we will provide the response to the user. If the user provides the correct user ID password, we will show something. If the user provides some incorrect user ID and password, then we will show something else. For validation of user ID and password, we will go for static comparison in this project. In the future project, we will go for dynamic validation by using database. So let us see what is there in the requirement. So requirement is going to be, obviously we should have the existing Spring Boot project, then we need three JSP. One already we have created, suppose index.jsp, which we have already created, that we will reuse it, and another two JSP extra we will create, and one controller. So let us go back to the Eclipse. So here, this is the Spring Boot project. Here we have src main web app web inf jsp, and this is what the index.jsp which we had created. Nothing is there, so simply a hello message we have created over here. Now we have also two Java files which got created by spring.io during creation of our Spring Boot web project. This is what the Java file which contains the main class, and first one is the servlet initializer for making our Spring Boot project as a web project. Now I will add a controller into this project. For that, what I will do, whichever package has been created, I will right click over here, means over the package I want to create another package, means a sub package you can say. Don't go for creating an independent package. For that you need to have something extra, that is component scan, that we will discuss later in the next upcoming videos. Right now we will right click over the package and go for new, then here is the package I want to create. So it is always better to go for creating a package first, because for every category of files or classes or interfaces we should have different packages. So I will name it as the package name as my controller, means the package name, complete package name, if I'll say it is going to be com.cyber.dev.spring.springdemo, then dot my controller. This is my controller is the sub package which we created inside the Spring Demo package. Okay, click on finish. So here the blank package got created. So it was previously available, another package has been added over here. Now go for creating the controller. Right click over here, new class. So here any class name you can provide, that's up to us. So I'll provide, suppose login controller. The name can be anything. Nothing you have to change. Click on finish. Then here we got a class named as login controller. The first thing we have to do over here, inside this login controller, we have to mention an annotation to specify this class is not an ordinary class, this is a controller class. So if you write art controller, C capital, then here is the, it says an error because it has not been imported. Something mistake is there. So here, control space, if I'll press, then spring.framework.stereotype is the annotation we need that is going to be available. So automatically this import statement appeared. So always it is better to go for control space bar so that you may not make any typo error. So this class is now not an ordinary class, it is a controller class. Now I will add the method for controller. So I have already written the method to make this video shortcut or less time consuming. I will explain it. So whichever error you are getting, because these are not imported. So here import, if you hover the mouse, it will ask to import. So request param also, I will import. So now this method is ready. Here is the method starting and ending. It's a very basic method, you can say. Only a if else statement is there. Both if and else return either success or fail respectively. In the method, let me explain you. This is what art request mapping is, an annotation which says regarding the URL which is going to be used to access this controller. So the value equals to login test I have used, you can use anything, slash login test. And this method is going to be accessed with the help of get method, because we have not mentioned any method type over here. Then comes the method name is login test. It is not mandatory to give the method name and as well as the URL same. You can give anything. I have given same. It is better, it's better to go for using same name so that later on when the code will increase, you will not get confused by looking at the method name. Then it return type is string. It is going to return a string type of data. And the two arguments which I have mentioned over here, first one and as well as second one, the two arguments. The first argument I have used a request param as the annotation. We specify which type of parameter this method is going to accept. And this parameter name is going to be UID, means when the form or HTML form will be submitted to this servlet, then it will have a form field named as UID. And this form field is going to be represented inside this Java program or inside this Java code by using UID variable. Both can be same, both can be different, that doesn't matter. But this string UID which we are mentioning, that is going to be the variable which we are going to use inside the program, as I have used over here. Same thing, द पास इज ऑल्सो देयर सेकेंड आर्ग्यूमेंट और सेकेंड पैरामीटर विच आई हैव मेंशनड अगेन सेम थिंग रिक्वेस्ट फॉरम वैल्यू इज पास रिक्वायर्ड यू कैन यूज फॉल्स और ट्रू इफ विल मेक ट्रू देन द पैरामीटर इज गोइंग टू बी मैंडेटरी नाउ आई हैव मेड इट फॉल्स देन इनसाइड दिस मेथड आई हैव जस्ट गॉन फॉर ए स्टैटिक कंपेरिजन एज आई सेड इन द बिगिनिंग आई विल नॉट गो फॉर एनी डायनामिक ऑपरेशन ओवर हियर जस्ट ए static comparison. Later on we will see how to go for database connection. For that we need entity, we need repository, some extra components we need. So right now I will make it simple. I will compare UID with A and pass with B. So equals method of string I have used to compare UID with A and pass with B. If this comparison success, then it will return success, else it will return fail. Okay. Now I need these two pages, success and fail, means success.jsp and fail.jsp. This is what the file name you can say without specifying .jsp, only the name of the file we have mentioned here. That means index.jsp already exist, we need success.jsp and fail.jsp. But prior to that, in index.jsp, we have to change a bit, means we have to add a form so that the user ID and password will be accepted from the user. So I have already made the form again to make this video shorter. It's a very simple thing. So here I created the form. You can see it's a very simple HTML form. It is going to have action as login test. What is this login test? The controller which you have created, the controller's URL is login test. Means whenever the form will be submitted, it will search for login test where this user ID and password is going to be used. Okay. So index.jsp has a form having the attribute as action. Action has the attribute as login test. I didn't use method. By default method is going to be get. So it can be post also, but if you will use post, then in controller you have to mention type of the method also as post. But by default it is get, and as well as in controller the default method is get. Since I have not mentioned any method in controller's request mapping, so I cannot mention over here method equals to post. If you want to mention method equals to get, you can, but that is by default. It is unnecessary to explicitly mention it. Then I have created a label to display user ID as a text. Then I have created this input text which has the name as UID. You can see the UID which is there is the name which already we have used in the request param. So that's why we have to name it as UID. And for the second one, I have gone for using password. The password which is the label, and for it we have a password field, input type equals to password. Again the name is pass. Here you can see I am going back to the controller. The request param value is pass. Pass means here we have to mention it pass. Finally the submit button, so that when we will submit, this will go to this login test and it will compare this user ID and password. Okay, let us save it and go for this two pages which we have mentioned in our controller. So right click on the JSP, go for creating new JSP file. I will make it as success. Automatically it will add .jsp as the extension. So here the page has been created. I will write something. Welcome. I will put a message. Welcome. your user ID and password are correct. This much I will put. Then I will go for fail.jsp. Again, same thing. Right click on the JSP folder, create JSP file, name it as fail. So here I will mention a message again. Invalid credential. So our project is ready, you can say. Now we can run the main application or main class, which has been given by spring.io, and we have kept it in our Spring project. So now right click on the file where the main method exists, run as Java application. This one you can do, or the file which you see, spring demo application.java, right click on it, run as Java application. So now if everything goes right, the Spring application will start. So here it has been started. You can see the port number, it has started in 8080. Now we can go to our preferred web browser. Suppose here I am using Chrome. I'll use localhost 80, localhost colon 8080. So here this is what the output from index.jsp. I'll use A as the user ID, password as B, then submit. So here you can see this welcome, your user ID and password are correct. This output came from success.jsp. If I'll mention something wrong, either user ID or password, there we are getting the output from fail.jsp. So this is how we can make a static validation project in Spring Boot. In next topic, we will discuss how to make it dynamic by adding database comparison with the help of Spring Boot entity and repository. I hope this will help you to build the project in the future. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed yet, and click on bell icon to get notified for the future projects. Thanks for watching.